Welcome to Sold with Webinars, a podcast that aims to uncover how the most successful experts, coaches, consultants, and e-learning course professionals sell their products and services exclusively through just one sales presentation or webinar. A simple, effective webinar can transform the business and life of a solopreneur. And this podcast will show you how other experts and entrepreneurs just like you are generating six and seven figures per year online with webinars. So let's get started. Hey, what's going on, experts? It's Joel here with a very special episode of Sold with Webinars. And today you are in for a very, very special treat. I hopped on a solo podcast for you today because I want to introduce you to a test that I'm going to be running that I'm quite nervous about. I'm not going to lie. I am going to be launching a test to figure out if what I have been preaching from the mountaintop, which is all about making your marketing as effective as possible, we're going to see if this actually holds true. If what I am saying actually holds true. So I'm putting a lot of marketing dollars and a lot of investment into running this test because I've been seeing some things in the industry that are quite revealing. I talk about that in the episode today. And I also challenge you to go do some research yourself. So I don't want to spoil what I'm talking about in the episode because it's pretty incredible. And I invite you to stick around and watch as this challenge and as this test goes through. Sound cool? You're going to love this episode today. Enjoy. And be sure that if you like this episode, send me an email at the end of this podcast, at the end of this episode, and let me know what you think. And if you really liked it, I would appreciate you giving me a review, an honest review of this podcast. So that's what I've got for you today. Let's jump right into today's episode. Hey, what's going on, experts? It's Joel here, and I'm going to pop in real quick with a solo episode today. I want to talk about something very interesting, very unique, sometimes very controversial. We're actually going to be running a test inside of our Experts Unleashed group. I want to give you a little bit of background about what this test is all about, what it means to you, what it means to my branding, and what it means to my opinions on the world of marketing and sales. So we just ended, I'm not entirely sure when this episode is going to air, but I just ended my last high ticket webinar workshop. We had 11 people fly in from all over the country to beautiful Lewiston. We talked about high ticket offers and we talked about how to attract the right types of people into your sales funnel, whether that's via webinar, whether that's a high ticket webinar, it doesn't matter. I want you guys to understand my belief on the world of marketing and sales. I posted this message a while ago on my social media profile and I asked my audience, what do you think comes first, the chicken or the egg? And I compared the chicken and the egg analogy to marketing versus sales, right? So in the world of your business, in the world of attracting new people into your audience, what do you think comes first, marketing or sales? Now, what's really ironic about what the responses that I got on this post was I actually got a guy who used to run my sales team, my phone sales team. He commented on my post and he said, marketing makes sales superfluous, or I don't know. I don't have a very good vocabulary, as you can tell. But basically, he's saying marketing makes sales easy. So his response was, marketing comes first before sales. Now, I don't understand why he said that, because that is totally not true. And here's what I mean by that. My opinion is that sales comes before the marketing. And I have a firm belief in raising people's awareness level on your offer to get permission to market to them. One of the biggest takeaways that I share with my clients is this idea that you want to get permission to market to them. And how do you get permission to market to them? It's not by offering anything free. It's not by offering anyone time on your calendar. In fact, when you do that, time on your calendar or your own personal input, okay, this is going to come with a very, very strong caveat. So just bear with me as I go through this lesson. All right. There's a time and place for marketing and sales, and I'm not trying, my intention here is not trying to rewrite the rule book on marketing. However, I know my primary audience is the small business entrepreneur, and people who come to work with me, they are likely launching, I don't have very many people that launch new businesses, but they're launching new products, and they want to quickly test if it's going to be valid or not, okay? And the way that we do that is we create messages that let people know, I've got an offer for you. Are you interested? Will you buy it? So what's fascinating about that is because I don't want to get a bunch of emails saying, well, Joel, you do podcasting. Isn't that branding? Isn't that free content? Blah, 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 blah. Yes, it is. Okay. That's why the caveat is here. Because right now in my business, I'm at a point where I'm in the nurture phase. I've got people who have come into my world, likely seeing an offer that I've already made to them, and they weren't ready to buy at that point. But they know I've got something to buy for them. They know that I've got offers for them. Now they listen to my content. Maybe the timing wasn't right. I'm not rewriting marketing and sales rule books, rewriting them, right? I'm just trying to make you 1,000 times more effective with your marketing. This goes with everything that I teach, okay? This goes along with testing your offers first to get permission to market to them. I want you to understand that so you don't think that I'm contradicting myself. So because of this, we are going to be running a little test. I am about to launch, and maybe it's already going to be launched, depending on whenever this gets released, whenever you're listening to this, but I'm going to be running a test of, so I'm about to relaunch a program called the Perfect Expert Package, where we are going to be showing experts how to escape the expert's curse, how to package their knowledge, how to explain what it is that they do in a clear, concise, and effective manner that enrolls new clients, enrolls new customers, and grows their business very, very quickly. It is a culmination of everything that I have learned and taught over the past 3 or 4 years in the world of digital entrepreneurship, online marketing, and sales. And I'm really excited about it because we are also relaunching our Facebook group, Experts Unleashed, where that is the community that we are building of high ticket experts, service providers, and people who have a mission and have a message to share with the world. So what is this challenge? What is this test that I'm going to be running? Well, I have seen in the digital marketing space something that I'm not going to release yet. This is going to be part of my test, so I don't want to tease it here. But of course, I'm going to be testing webinar funnels, a form of my webinar funnel. It's going to be like a free 5-day challenge that I don't even know if I can even promote it as a free 5-day challenge, but it is going to be 5 days of free content and then leading into the webinar funnel. So the test is going to be comparing the two. It's going to be comparing, just so I make sure I get this clear, and because I feel like what I just explained wasn't 100% crystal clear. So the two funnels that I'm going to be running simultaneously, which are ultimately going to be selling my Perfect Expert Package, it's going to be around $2,000, and I'm going to have, I think, a $5,000 and an $8,000 package as well. So those are the ball price ranges for this. So the two funnels that I'm going to be testing, to be clear, are number one, the cold traffic to the webinar and selling straight from the webinar from cold traffic, okay? And the second funnel that we are going to be running is going to be a 5-day challenge opt-in, which puts them into our Experts Unleashed group. And the challenge is called Escape the Expert's Curse Challenge. It's going to be a 5-part challenge. And at the end, they are going to be invited to that same webinar that I'm running cold traffic straight to. So I'm going to be seeing what is more effective, going from the 5-day challenge to the webinar to the sale, or leveraging my framework and going straight from cold traffic to the webinar to the sale. So that is what we are going to be testing. And who knows, maybe I'm going to eat my words. I'm not entirely sure. And what I can say is I've got a couple of tests that are already running, and they're not comparing free versus this isn't the direct comparison, but I've seen a form of webinar funnel that I've been running with a couple of my clients that is absolutely crushing it. They are not necessarily running it at the price point that I am, which is going to be around 2K, but it is working very, very well. So it'll be interesting. I haven't run any of these funnels before, these challenge funnels, but the whole reason why I wanted to hop on this podcast is, and I probably should have led with this, but this is really, really important. The reason why I led with this podcast was because I just joined. And so as we are building this 5-day challenge funnel, and I've got my team working on that and they're helping to launch it, it's going to be run inside of our Facebook group. And so I think ultimately having that inside of my marketing funnel absolutely will improve the quality of customers and leads that I have coming into my world, into my ecosystem. But it's just all about what is more effective for launching new offers. And that is what I'm not entirely sure about. So as we've been doing this, and as I've been doing more research on Facebook groups, I came across some other people who are promoting, like monetize and grow Facebook groups. And I saw recently somebody, one of these gurus, had said, hey, how I make $50,000 per month with my Facebook group. And so I don't know him personally, but I've chatted with him a couple times and I like him and he's a super smart guy and he's got a lot of great things going for him. And I totally respect what he's doing. Very, very smart in his field. So I had jumped into their Facebook group and I saw that the membership size was 70,000 members, which means that if they really are making $50,000 per month from 70,000 members, they're making less than a dollar per member per month. And if you know anybody in the world of list building and email marketing, you will know that that is a terrible earnings per subscriber rate. I think most people are shooting for at least $1 earnings per subscriber, and that's probably with a consumer and a mass market list. If you're in the high ticket space, if you're in the expert space, I don't know if I've ever made a dollar per. If I was at a dollar per subscriber, I would be out of business. Anyway, I just thought that was unique. And so that was the real reason why I hopped on this episode, is because I wanted to talk about that. I wanted to share with you this upcoming test that we are going to be launching. You'll probably see some promotions for it as we launch that challenge inside of the group. And I do expect those our conversion rate numbers to be relatively high when we do the launch, because I'm going to launch it to my internal list first. But then I'll be turning cold traffic onto it and running it simultaneously to the webinar funnel versus the 5-day challenge that leads to the funnel. So it's adding an additional step. And who knows? I may come back on here and eat my words and I may have to say, you know what? I'm wrong. Lead with free. You guys will be better off doing that and we shall see. So I will report back with those results in a future episode. But until then, we'll talk to you soon. I hope you enjoyed this. And if you did, shoot me a comment. Well, I've got a couple of asks for you. So if you enjoy this content, if you enjoyed this episode, do me a favor and shoot me a comment. Send me an email over at joel@thewebinaragency.com and just let me know, hey, what did you think about this episode? And if you really liked it and you want to help support this podcast and support my efforts here, it would mean the world to me if you went over to iTunes or wherever you listened to this podcast and just give it a completely honest rating with whatever you feel this podcast should be rated. That would help me get my message out and impact and influence more marketers and more experts with getting their message to the world. So those are my two asks of you today. And thanks for tuning in. I'll see you on the next Sold with Webinars episode. Take care. Thanks so much for listening. We hope you enjoyed today's episode and we look forward to giving you the next one. If you're serious about launching your own sales webinar, here are a few resources to check out. For free access to the software that we built internally for the webinar agency to train our copywriters, head to soldwithwebinars.com to sign up for a free trial to the webinar vault and get access to regular webinar breakdowns that are generating hundreds of thousands of dollars per month. If you'd like to work with me one-on-one on your webinar project, head to thewebinaragency.com for more details. And finally, be sure to subscribe to my other podcast, Experts Unleashed, where I interview changemakers and entrepreneurs to discover how they create opportunity to turn their expertise into income. Be sure to join us next time, and I'll see you there.